We're in the glorious sunshine of Sutton Coalfield, supporting the Stiliyan Petrov Foundation. Should be a cracking game this, the Rigger and Petrov 11 against the Lions and Legends. The fans have turned out in their droves. Great to see. What's your name, mate?
My name's Martin.
Martin, fantastic cause, isn't it? And wonderful to see so many supporters here.
I think it's a great occasion for Stiliyan, great serving for the Villa. It's unlucky, really, the fact that his career's been cut short, but always be remembered, mate, and it's a good occasion for today and for the nods of the fans turning out as well.
Spink, Staunton, Cowans, Brand, the Morley, McNaught. That is quite a turnout. Now then, Kyle, you're a massive Villa fan, mate. Great to see you. How much are you looking forward to seeing that the Legends play today?
Very, because I haven't seen Petrov play since he retired, so it's nice to see him back in action again. Yeah.
What are your memories of watching Stan?
I remember him scoring from the halfway line.
There's Petrov, and Powell's out of his goal here. He's gone for it. He's found the net. That is a special, special goal.
Have you got any pre-match butterflies or anything like that?
A bit nervous now. It's getting closer. But just trying to enjoy the day at the same time. You know what I mean? Everyone's raring to go and just can't wait to, you know, enjoy it, basically.
Let's head into the dressing rooms ahead of the Lions and Legends against Rigger and Stans 11.
All the boys are excited. We're looking forward to it. You know, Stevie, he did most of the things, and we're looking to make people happy for a great cause as well. And I hope that everybody will enjoy it, and the main things the players will enjoy as well.
Days like this brings everybody together, and everybody's getting autographs, and you know, and it's just got a good feel about the place.
The Lions and Legends raced into the lead on 13 minutes. Lee Hendry with a delightful ball forward and Tony Morley rolling back the years to lift over the keeper. It was soon one apiece though. Alan Wright, great to see him out there, for Julian Joachim to equalise for the Petrov 11. Petrov's boys went ahead on 21. Paul Merson won a penalty, and there was the man himself, Stan, showing the quality to rattle home the spot kick to make it 2-1. The pendulum kept swinging. Ryan Amu equalised for the Legends. And then Lee Hendry, who was playing some superb football, made it 3-2. Darren Byfield was next up to score for the men in white. 4-2. And then an own goal and 5-2 at the interval. Julian Joachim got one back, 5-3. Ken McNaught is a concerned-looking manager here. I was hoping we'd see you play, mate, but you got a watching brief.
I've had the job for an hour. Yeah. Stress is killing me.
You're like a Roman emperor surveying his empire. So they've got you back to 5-3. Are you worried?
It was never built in a day, was it?
No.
No, first game of the season. Good occasion, great weather. Fantastic to see so many names out there. You know, terrific. Great turnout. It's all for a good cause, and that's what it's all about at the end of the day, Jack.
Byfield, with his second of the afternoon, gave them a cushion again. The Lions and Legends 6-3 ahead. And fan Ryan Nichols grabbed some glory to make it 7-3. The scoring was completed by Dean Langston, much to the delight of his fans at the ground. Well, an 8-3 win for the Lions and Legends, largely down. So this fella, Lee, how much did you enjoy that, mate?
His quality was great. You know, it's a great turnout today. I mean, what a great cause, you know, what a legend Stan is. Just shows all the people that care so much for him. And, you know, for a turnout like this on a beautiful day, couldn't have asked for anything more.
Yeah. And you've provided some good entertainment for the fans who've turned up.
You know me. I'm always one for entertainment. I've still got my competitive side a little bit. But, no, it was great. It was, you know, I mean... good values, you know, seeing the likes of Merce, Wrighty, Jockey, by for, you know, fantastic players. And, you know, I mean, it must have been good to watch for everyone. You know, it was a great day.
All funds raised today go to the Stiliyan Petrov Foundation. You know, he's been on quite a journey, hasn't he?
I know Stan well enough, and what a great guy he is, you know, off the pitch. You know, what we know what he's like on the pitch, but what a fantastic man off the pitch. And to do stuff that he does, you know, his foundation, it's just fantastic. He's a great guy, and it just wraps up everything what he's about. You know, he's a superb on and off the pitch. I mean, what a great guy. He's a role model to look up to young kids.
I think footballers in general, whether they're playing still or ex-players, they'll do what they can to help charities. And as we said, the fact that Stiliyan's been through what he's been through and he's come out the other end of it. So, yeah, it's well worth the while. I think the weather's played a big part, but I still think the fans would have turned out in the droves as they have done. So credit to them as well. They can see what the cause is for, and it's been all in all a very good day. Yeah.
Julian Joachim's still got it as well, hasn't he?
He can shift jockey. He could play. he could run when he played, but he can still run now. But he's still sharp as ever. So he's still a good player, to be fair. Yeah.
Merce had his moments.
Yeah, I'm not too sure about the first kickoff when he shanked it out of play, but you never lose that quality. It's just that your body won't allow you to do what your head's telling you to. So it's still got that quality in there, though.
Stan, fantastic day. How much did you enjoy that?
I've really enjoyed it. You know, it's the turn up. You know, today it was a sunny day as well. I've really enjoyed it. You know, it's my first 90 minutes for a long time. I was blowing at one point, but Stevie. He done a great job. You know, I didn't have much time to help him, and the organization was brilliant. You know, everything was great, and the turn up as well, and I really enjoyed it.
A nicely taken penalty from you in the first half as well.
The boys tried to play, could they give me that one? the keeper didn't even try. Yeah, but it was a good penalty anyway. Listen, I really enjoyed it. Everybody out there put a shift and. You know, we drew the game, so that was important. We're playing next run away.
You only down to 7-7, was that right?
7-7. Yeah, we were leading until last minute they scored. No, it wasn't about the result. You know, we really enjoyed it. You know, some good goals today. I think the fans enjoyed it as well. And like I said, the turn up was great. So it's been a very busy couple of months. And, you know, today, again, I've got a couple more events coming up. And, you know, it's been a hard work, but I really enjoy it.
And today is just an example of how the football world have supported you. How impressed have you been with the response you've had?
I've always said that if everybody in any situation, any hard situation, any disease or anything, if they have the support that I had, it's so helping. You know, it's to be honest, when I got diagnosed, and you know, all the football world and all my friends and people that I don't even know, they try to be part of it, you know. They don't need to, but they were part of it. They want to know what's happening with me. They want to help. They want to be part of my fight, you know, which is incredible.
A mini pitch invasion at full time. What a fantastic game. Tremendous entertainment. The Lions and Legends winning by 8-3. Exciting stuff, quality goals, and the worthiest of worthy causes.